Hey y'all, long time no vlog. Honestly, I just really needed a bit of a break from everything. The holidays rolled around, then I got really, really busy with a lot of things, and I just felt like I needed some time off. But I am really happy to be back in vlogging because these next few months are going to be very, very exciting months. Lots and lots of things are happening, and I want to capture them all. Not only to share with you guys, but also for myself to capture. We'll have bridal showers coming up, bachelorettes coming up, weddings coming up. It's going to be pretty crazy. But this weekend, I am headed to Toronto to do a few things bridal related, but then also celebrating Jen's 30th birthday. My best friend is turning 30, the big 30. And we're going to have a party after not being able to celebrate her birthday really for, I think, like two years now. So I'm the one driving down to Toronto. Since you guys last saw me, you'll know that I got my license at that point, and then I bought a car in December. And since then, we've been to Toronto a few more times, and I've practiced my driving. So the first time I drove 1 hour, the second time I drove like 2 hours, last time back I drove like 3 hours, and now I think I'm gonna drive like 3 in a little bit. I don't really like driving once we get right into downtown Toronto, but it's been really helpful for Ty. Have you liked that I've been driving a lot lately?
Oh, it's the best.
All right, first stop, we made it to Toronto and I had to go get my hair cut. Look at all the fun layers I have now. Yay, and I got myself shorter curtain bangs this time because last time we did like a long curtain bang, but I think I feel brave now to do a shorter one. Love it. Thank you, Erica from NC Salon. She always cuts my hair and it looks great every single time. Now I'm gonna go meet some colleagues for dinner at Charisma, which is an Italian restaurant here. And I've yet to try it actually, so I'm excited. So we're at Laura Mercier today and they will be doing the Bridesmaids makeup trial for Jen. She has no makeup.
See my naked.
You're beautiful.
Face.
You're beautiful. They will actually be coming to do my bridesmaids makeup at my wedding, which is super exciting. And then they're also going to be giving me some bridal makeup tips as well for all different styles of dresses, which you guys will see in a bit.
We start off with the micellar water. And then I didn't even know that Laura Mercier had skincare. We use the Perfect Cream moisturizer and then the eye cream, which you can really see when she was putting on. It had like shimmer and like illuminating factors to it, so I think it'll do well for under eyes.
See how like how hydrated the skin looks?
Yeah, so you did the hydrating one first.
Yeah, and now just around here, I'm gonna put the blurring one.
So you're using the blurring just in certain spots?
And I don't do that for everybody, but just because she has like a bit of pores, it's just gonna help with that. But a lot of people think like, oh, really hydrating glowy is not gonna like last.
Yeah.
That like long throughout the day, but this is actually gonna like stay on.
Okay, so and why the tinted moisturizer and the foundation?
So I just wanted to give like a bit of glow with like a hint of coverage and an extra touch of hydration. So that's why I wanted to do a bit of the tinted moisturizer first. It's a very soft, natural glow, and it's customized to like her skin tone and skin level. So I'm gonna get the most sort of like natural looking glow by using that.
Got it.
And this is like a Laura Mercier trick. So when you think about where makeup tends to sort of like look heavy throughout the day, it tends to be down the
It gets cakey down the middle, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So if you start with like the bulk of pigment there, a lot of, it gives it an opportunity to settle and sit.
Yeah.
But if you stretch the pigment from the outside in, and because we're using the Lumiere foundation, it's very pigmented, so you don't need a lot of product to get a really nice coverage. It's gonna allow it to then still give you the coverage, but it's not gonna settle because we're working from the outside of the contour, so
you're
gonna
center
it all. So it's 2 pens, a customizable color. We're gonna mix to customize your shape. So this is gonna look like skin. It's not dewy, it's not too matte, it just looks like skin, and it's a super natural finish. Secret brightening powder is like, imagine you took a mirror and you put it in a blender and ground it up into like a super, super, super fine powder. So with the secret brightening powder, it's going to add a touch of airbrush to the under eye, but it's also going to work like a magic trick to like reflect darkness away throughout the day. Okay. I like to start and rest where I know the concealer creases first.
Okay, now we're at Kleinfeld's to do some wedding looks. And we're gonna show how we kind of change up makeups based off of different wedding dress styles. And it's stunning in here. My waist looks snatched. To grab some lunch with the team after all the dress trying on, and now we're at Kemba Fire to get Ty's ring. Let's see, put one on. Let's see. Ooh, you're a new man. Does it feel weird? I never see you wear rings, so it's like new to me.
I used to wear it when I was younger.
I've never seen you wear it. Never. Oh, it's not gonna be on your thumb, dude.
It's gonna be on my thumb.
What are you reaching out there, Ty?
Pretty good. Which looking at the thickness and finishes. I think we agreed on this.
We're going to see the premiere of Cirque du Soleil Curios. Okay, so we just came back from watching Cirque, and we grabbed some dinner because I didn't have dinner yet, you didn't have dinner, we didn't have dinner. All we had was popcorn for dinner, and now it's 11 o'clock, actually almost 11:30, and we are getting some dinner. We got hand-pulled noodles. Got this last time we were here too, or no, in December when we were here. It's really good. And you got the braised beef one? I'm not even gonna wait for you, I'm so hungry, I'm going in.
Don't wait, bro,
I'm going
don't
in.
Wait.
Okay, I was doing my hair and styling my curtain bangs, and I just burnt my forehead. So badly, look at that. So I tried to put a little bit of foundation around there, as you can see, but I didn't want to put on the open wound part because that part, the skin has peeled and it's bleeding a little bit. What degree burn is this considered? Because it's still hurting me really bad. Oh, it looks so nasty. Anyways, good thing I have curtain bangs. This will cover it for the most part. Just like that, I'll just do a little bit of that, you know, and we're good to go. We're gonna go to Ching's house today to visit her new house, and then we're going to Miku after that to try out their Sakura Kiseki menu, which I'm really, really, really excited about. And then we're gonna go see Rosa and Winnie later today. Babe, can you put some lotion on my back? I'm really dry. Ching made us a brunch spread. Yummy. And now we're at Miku to try their Sakura Kaiseki menu, which is set menu. I'm really excited. There's duck and there's also sable fish and a bunch of other things. So we're excited. I'm gonna show you guys what we got. And I got polysporin for my burn. So now I have polysporin on it. Alright, here is the first course.
I am not gonna remember every single thing that he told us, but one thing that stood out to me is the broccoli with the cured egg like shred, which is interesting. This is fish. This is fish as well, I think.
That one's fish. Yeah. This is okami on top of something with dried shrimp.
This is like something with clam.
Clam tofu.
We're so bad.
With clam tofu. Clam tofu with octopus.
Okay. All right. Next we have the fish dish, which is like the surf of the surf and turf. It's a sea bream with some asparagus, and I don't know what's on top, but the bottom is asparagus and mushrooms, which look delicious. Look how pretty the plate is. Babe, the plate is so pretty, huh? Alright, now the turf, which is the duck breast, some foie gras, other rooty, hearty vegetables. That looks good. Oh yeah, okay, this is what I'm excited for. So, there's this lobster. Babe, hamachi. Salmon, wagyu, fatty fish, and belt fish? Some sort of fish.
I just had the lobster one, it was so good. Lobster, but I think like truffle or something like that. Oh my god, that was so good.
That one. You wanna try that one? Yeah? I could do like 5 more of those.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna do the wagyu. Fire the
story. Our last course is a dessert. There's some mint ice cream, some ginger, like icy stuff. I can't describe this. There's so many things.
All right, here we go. Okay. This is parfait.
Uh-huh.
It has white chocolate twill. Okay.
Okay.
Sakura strawberry boba.
No, she's a black currant.
Tapioca.
She's
black currant. Sorry, black currant tapioca.
Cookie crumbles.
Cookie. White chocolate cookie crumble.
Mm-hmm. Strawberries.
No, this one is this. What's called the powder is Sakura
and
white chocolate powder with cream, like what's called a cream.
Let's just eat it. I'm hungry.
Yeah, let's just eat it.
Honestly, it pleasantly surprised me. Everything kind of like works well together, huh? Like the mint ice cream is so refreshing, and I don't usually like mint ice cream. And then like with the like I don't know, gingery something here, it's so good. And with the straw, I don't know, everything just works. It works.
Strawberry mint.
It works.
So we're back in Ottawa now, and yeah, we got here pretty quickly today, this morning. Last night we went to Jen's birthday, and she KO'd pretty quickly. I think within 3 hours she was down and out for the count. So in the last couple of months I've been really obsessed with sourdough. I've always really liked sourdough, but like recently I've been so obsessed with like trying different sourdoughs, and Ottawa doesn't have that many sourdough options. So when I go to Toronto, I try to like bring home a couple sourdoughs. Last time I tried one from Sud Forno, and it was like a seeded one, and it was pretty good, like very like a lot of depth to it, and the taste itself was very different. This time I went to Blackbird and I got 2 sourdough loaves. So this is my sourdough haul. So I have here the Baldwin loaf, and then this is a Kensington loaf, and I'm just about to give a little bit of a try, and I'm gonna throw one of them in the freezer since I'm not gonna finish it all. Other sourdoughs that I've tried that I really like, one of my favorite sourdoughs is by The Drake, and then I had some from Dear Grain, which I really, really liked. Actually, my manager had sent me stuff from Dear Grain because she knows that I love sourdough, so she sent me 2 loaves that were delicious. I tried Farm Boy one time because I do like their baked goods. It was like pretty good. I would buy it again, but it wasn't my favorite.
I didn't toast it, so it's not the same. I feel like if you don't toast it, you don't get the texture. I should toast it.